What I want to talk to you about today is the risk of subsequent brain injury for those who have already had a brain injury. My name is Gordon Johnson. I am an attorney. I've been writing about the second TBI and the risk of the second TBI for many years on my webpage. The reason I'm bringing it up today is there's a recent study out of Sweden that confirms in a very large-scale study what we have all suspected for a long time, that having a TBI is dangerous. It's dangerous for you to have another. The study is called Suicide, Fatal Injuries, and Other Causes of Premature Mortality in Patients with Traumatic Brain Injury. What does that mean? It means if you've had a brain injury, you're more likely to die as a result. You're more likely to die in what they call premature deaths than if you'd not had one. This is an important study, first because it confirms things that we had understood on a subjective level, but second, because of the large number of people involved in this study, it's probably the largest number of people ever really been included in a study like this. There are 218,000 people in this study who'd had a brain injury, and they're compared to 2.6 million people who were considered normals who had not had brain injuries. It's three times as likely for you to die early if you have a TBI. The primary reasons focused on in this study are suicide, additional injuries, and assault. And I want to talk about those three issues and remind people of something I've been saying for a long time. Every symptom of brain injury increases the probability that you're going to have a subsequent brain injury. From my perspective, and this isn't completely the focus of the study, but from my perspective, the first symptom that makes brain injury dangerous is when brain injury also affects a person's balance. Falls are the number one cause of brain injury, and people with impaired balance, which often occurs after brain injury, are more likely to fall. The second problem that I want to talk about is attention and concentration problems. If you are not attending well, if you get easily distracted, you're more likely to get hurt. You're more likely to get hurt in a fall, and you're considerably more likely to get hurt driving an automobile. There's probably nothing more troublesome than someone with a brain injury being distracted while they're driving. They tend to zoom in on one type of stimuli and ignore all others. And nowhere more so than behind the wheel of a car do you need to be aware of your entire environment. Another problem that people with brain injuries have that increases the probability of falls is seizures. People with brain injuries who have seizures do fall from the seizures. The primary focus of the Swedish study was psychiatric causes. They highlighted this as the single biggest reason for increased mortality. And one of the psychiatric issues, and the one they're particularly focused on, is the risk of suicide. The other neurobehavioral aspects of a brain injury significantly increase the probabilities of having a brain injury. People with frustration, people with temper problems, people with deep despair, people who just can't seem to feel comfortable around other people, those people are all more likely to have suicide. They're all more likely to be distracted and get in some type of accident. And the third major cause in the Swedish study is assault. And people with temper problems, people with frustration problems, people with neurobehavioral issues, getting along with others, are much more likely to be victims of assault than the average person. Another major issue that contributes to problems after brain injury in terms of having accidents, in terms of having being victims of assault, is disinhibition. When you blurt things out you shouldn't, you're more likely to piss off someone else. You're more likely to make someone else angry, and that increases the likelihood of an assault. What the Swedish study found is that the probabilities of having suicide, the probabilities of having accidents, the probabilities of having assaults are all greatly increased with people who have problems with alcohol. There are a number of aspects of brain injury that contribute to alcohol problems, but there is probably also a sensitivity in the brain to alcohol that makes people with brain injury that much more impaired when they have alcohol in them. many, many years, we've called it the six-pack effect. That is something where two beers are the equivalent of a six-pack. Alcohol is very dangerous for people for brain injury. We know this situationally. We know this from subjective analysis. But this study has made that very, very clear. The key to this study, as we think about where we go forward, is we must not only plan for the normal symptoms that people have brain injury, we have to do prevention planning so that as they go forward into their future, they're less exposed to falls, they're less exposed to assaults, and that we have treated the entire totality of the brain injury, dealt with the emotional issues, dealt with the behavioral issues, and accepted the suicide issue as one that we say aloud and we're willing to treat. Thank you.